In 2002, a man from Uttar Pradesh, Pradeep Kumar, was arrested on espionage charges. And 22 years later, Kumar is all set to become the additional district judge. Let's discuss the full story, but before that, do subscribe to HW News English. Last week, the Allahabad High Court ordered the Uttar Pradesh government to issue the letter appointing 46-year-old Pradeep Kumar as additional district judge. According to an Indian Express report, in 2002, an unemployed law graduate, Pradeep Kumar, was accused of carrying out espionage activities for Pakistan and charged with sedition, criminal conspiracy, and various provisions of the Official Secrets Act. Kumar faced two trials and a stint in jail before being acquitted by a Kanpur court in 2014. According to a July 2019 report of the military authority to the Kanpur district magistrate, which the High Court took note of, Kumar was arrested in a joint operation by the Special Task Force and Military Intelligence on June 13, 2002, based on inputs received from sister intelligence agencies. According to the report, Kumar's father was also found to be suspended from the service of an additional judge for charges of bribery in 1990. The report claimed that Kumar, in search of easy money options, had come in contact with a person named Faizan Ilahi, who ran a photostat shop and who allegedly asked him to provide him some sensitive information on call in exchange for money. The report further claimed that Kumar passed on sensitive information of the Kanpur cantonment in exchange for money. In 2014, a Kanpur court acquitted him and said the prosecution must demonstrate that the accused has expressed or attempted to incite hate or contempt towards the government through words, signs, or visible representations. In this case, there is no evidence on record from the prosecution's witness to substantiate claims of such actions against the government, the court said in its order. In 2016, later, Kumar applied for the UP Higher Judicial Service under the UP Higher Judicial Service Direct Recruitment Examination 2016, securing the 27th position in the merit list. On August 18, 2017, the High Court recommended his appointment, along with other selected candidates, to the state government. However, Kumar was not issued an appointment letter. Pradeep Kumar then knocked the doors of the High Court, which in August 2017 directed the state government to present the matter to the governor within 2 weeks and obtain an opinion within the following month after consulting relevant authorities. The court also directed the state to proceed with the appointment if necessary. The court also imposed a cost of rupees 10 lakh on the state for its indifferent attitude and delay in acting on its recommendation regarding the petitioner. The order was not challenged. Subsequently, the matter was reviewed by the state government, which through an office memorandum dated September 26, 2019, declined to appoint the petitioner. Kumar then filed a fresh petition in the Allahabad High Court seeking to quash the state government's 2019 order and seeking appointment as additional district judge in the Uttar Pradesh Higher Judicial Service. The High Court on December 6 passed an order quashing the state government order and asked for Kumar to be appointed against existing vacancies after carrying out a character verification of the petitioner within a period of 2 weeks. A division bench of Justices Soumitra Dayal Singh and Donadi Ramesh in its order said, consequentially, upon completion of all formalities, appointment letter may be issued to the petitioner not later than 15th January 2025. The petitioner may be appointed against existing vacancies as on date. This modified relief we have granted because though selected against vacancy of 2017, neither those vacancies survive in the light of the provision of UP Higher Judicial Service rules and also the petitioner does not have any work experience in the HJS cadre for the last 7 years. No material exists with the state respondents to reach a conclusion that the petitioner may have worked for any foreign intelligence agency. The fact that he may have been on the radar of the Indian intelligence agencies itself means nothing. To be suspected of an offense is not an offense or a scar on a citizen's character. To say a citizen would continue to be suspected of an offense alleged and therefore be deprived of fruits of hard labor and honorable acquittal earned by him would be to not only vicariously penalize an innocent citizen after his innocence has been established in a court of law, but it would successfully militate against the rule of law itself, guaranteed by the Constitution, the court said. We also spoke to the president of the International Court of Jurists and former Supreme Court Bar Association president Adish Agarwal. Listen in to his reaction on the High Court's order.
You see, there is nothing wrong. Somebody was arrested under such charges, but when it was ultimately found that he was not really involved, and that's why he was not punished. There was no evidence, concrete evidence to prove. Then he is treated as innocent, ordinary citizen, and that's why the High Court has directed that he should be appointed immediately by January. The appointment letter should be issued.
That's it for this news report. For more such news and updates, subscribe to HW News English.
Stay ahead with our cutting edge news app. Instantly access the latest shorts in just 1 minute and breaking news in just 50 words. Download now for a smarter, faster news experience.